ethically and ethically the rules, and a committee report regarding the change, the system's governance, doctrines, and teaching practices in our subject of parallel education system, or the e-education, in the graduate school of EUP Mobilis. And to start with, in our country, or most countries in Asia, there is a change of systems governance structures and rigid management practices. And what are these? Actually, we are governed by our own government. So there is a governance structure. And these are led by the presidents, the Senate, the congressmen, down the line, the run by captain. And also, we have some management that we share. And most of the education, like in the Philippines, which is a part of the third world country, we have a public tertiary institution. So once you say public tertiary institution, these governs the higher education or the colleges and the university. However, since we have a pyramid here, they're all being characterized by the family, characterized by the weaknesses of leadership, a total lack of regularity, and management flexibility. So once we say weak leadership, it confers in the administrative positions that leads the institutions. If not, the total lack of regularity deals with the bios, deals with the rules and regulations, and the management flexibility is the changes that happen in the organizational structures. And these three are being included, the effective reforms of the institutions, and the further changes and innovation of the said institution. For these are inhibitions of reforms and innovation, likewise, in the tertiary public education, mostly academic freedom is being mistakenly equated with managerial independence. This managerial independence meaning we are using this tertiary ideas or opinion, and we said that it is pure academic freedom. It is also similar to the academic speech, meaning to say the freedom of speech. Some institutions are not accountable for their use of public resources. What are these? This could be in means of resources, meaning the things that already exist in the campuses, or meaning the resources, or meaning the public fund for quality of their output, quality of their end product of education. So if that is the case, it all needs academic freedom. There are certain inefficiencies, particularly it gives rise to poor academic practices. In some tertiary institution, some of the owner has the copy from those who should be the main client, and who should be our main client. These are the educators. These are the learners, these are the teaching staff, and those that are capable to run the institution. What they do is, it is controlled by the teaching staff. And that is the basic scenario that we have in the Philippines. Why? Instead of serving their own client, which is the learner, what they do is they provide staff employment, meaning to say they give jobs to those who are graduated already and have passed the qualifying test for employment, and they provide staff benefits, even though some of the priorities that should be meant for the learners should be given, we are being diverted to the benefit of this staff that govern the entire institution. So, for these two benefits, or the advantages of all the employment, that is, meaning to say, we have to counterfeit it, and that is to Minister of Educational Establishment focus primarily on the needs of the students and labor market. What are these labor markets? These labor markets are considered to be the future job of our present learners. So what would be our resolution for this? In some public tertiary education, before privatize certain institutions, colleges and universities. So if that's the case, there will be less students or learners that will go to those particular academic institutions. Why? Because of increased tuition fees and expensive cost of education. Okay, there are also these tuition that has a government structure. So that is allowing for the participation by representatives of local employers of student civil society. So often the management and support do not provide guidance in the form of monitoring. So we have this comparison. Take for example in the University of Bangladesh, in the University of in Russia and Bolivia, what they do is they do not have a board of trustees. Meaning there are no selected individuals that would run the institution. What they do is that it is the country or it is the leader of the country that runs the particular universities in this given countries. Since we do not manage their support system, we do not provide guidance in the form of monitoring and evaluation of institutions' performance, meaning that the staff are not being evaluated if they are affecting or not. So what are the different consequences of it? First, it leads to a political rather than professional system of management and governance. Next is the consequence in the governance system that plus flexibility that you know the team capacity. This particular bullet deals with a certain difficulty of the program is being developed to serve the needs of the existing staff rather than the country's development goal. And basically what is the country's development goal? This is to provide learnings and skills to be ready to those who are skilled learners.